Hey guys, so we have some energy today that is really bringing in sort of like the heights of intensity. There may be some very powerful conversations, encounters, interactions going on today, kind of profound, that maybe really, really transform our mind, our viewpoint, our attitude about something in some type of a way. We are in the thick of some big time secrets revealed energy, you guys. Shady business that's been going on behind the scenes of things, deceit, things that have been hidden or coercive or manipulative, corruption. There is a light that is shining directly into that type of darkness today and moving through this week, you guys. We have both of our luminaries today in an aspect with Pluto. We have the moon opposing Pluto. We also have the sun forming a trine to Pluto. We're also in black moon energy. So we are very, very much shining some light into the shadows today. And another dynamic of this energy, especially the sun trining Pluto, the sun is in Virgo right now, you guys, and Mercury is the ruler of Virgo. Mercury is currently retrograde in an exact, basically, opposition to Jupiter. Jupiter brings the truth. Jupiter exposes things. So not only are we shining the light into the darkness today in some pretty profound ways, but we are also gaining an elevated viewpoint somehow. Big news, big information, somebody's big mouth revealing something to us in one way or another that really like changes things for us or sparks a change going on within us in one way or another. Lots and lots of energy to talk about today, you guys. Let's get into the chart. Let's see what this breakdown looks like and how perhaps it may be affecting us in our experience today. Welcome back to my channel, you guys. Today is Tuesday, September 20th, 2022. My name is Aubrey, and this is your astrological outlook of the day. If you guys stick with me until the very end of the report, we're also going to be talking about some tarot cards that came out in correspondence to our astrology today, just because I like to tap the field from more than one modality to just get a more well-rounded overview of what's playing out for us on an energetic level. But we're going to start with the astrology, as we always do, you guys. And today, it's, oh man, it is intense out there. There may be some very powerful emotions going on, impulses, urges to do things, encounters with other people, like dialogues, conversations, just this like air of like, I mean, intensity and just like almost like a seriousness, like profoundness, kind of power. Power is the key word of the day. And it's very interesting because we also actually have the sun today at 28 degrees of Virgo. And that Sabian symbol is a bald headed man in uniform who has seized power. I feel like this is talking about mentalized power as well. Because before I really get into all of this, you know, the context through which we need to be viewing these aspects that are going on are in regards to Mercury, current ruler of our Virgo cycle that we are in, and that is rapidly coming to a close this week. We are approaching our new moon in Libra this week, but Mercury right now is still the ruler of this cycle and is in basically an exact opposition to Jupiter in the sky retrograde. This is expanding our viewpoint. This is big news, big information, specifically in regards to perhaps things from the past as well in this retrograde energy that are really shifting and changing our mindset, our viewpoint, our understanding, our attitude about stuff, okay? So that is like the foundation energy that we have playing out as Mercury ruling our current cycle is in this aspect right now with Jupiter. And the sun today is in the sign of Virgo, of course, which is ruled by Mercury. So Mercury is ruling the current position of the sun today as well in the trine to Pluto. So, you know, at the end of the day, what we know that this is all ultimately stemming from is some type of revelation or illumination or recognition or rediscovery, reevaluation with this retrograde energy going on in regards to the truth about something. Jupiter represents and rules truth in the sign of Aries. This has a lot to do with our personal truth or the personal truth of others as well. Aries and Libra, another dynamic that we are working with right now, and we are moving towards this Libra cycle. We're about to be discovering a lot of truths about ourselves and a lot of truths about others. And people are likely, I feel like also another dimension of the energy as it's playing out today, I feel like people are possibly coming clean about some stuff maybe that they've been holding on to for a long period of time that's been like really weighing them down and really like bringing up feelings of like guilt and stuff like that. I feel like people may be coming clean about some stuff somehow in this energy is like one dynamic and dimension of things. But with all of this Pluto energy going on today. Pluto rules the underworld, you guys, and it's also regeneration and purging and transformation. It's purifying things. It's the Phoenix energy. It's where things break down. It's death and rebirth. It's the breakdown and the destruction for the purpose of the growth and evolution into like a more divine and just like refined, evolved state of things. And when we're dealing in all this Pluto energy today, like this also has to do with things that have been hidden from us, things that have been under the surface. Pluto also in the last degrees of Capricorn, this can really in a lot of ways pertain to situations and power and control dynamics as well. Long-standing power and control dynamics. We may find something out in this energy that really like shakes the foundation of these dynamics and sort of leads to a pending shift of power, which is like right on the horizon now, as we, you know, are in this age of Aquarius energy. We are shifting paradigms right now, but there's a lot of energetic shifts going on in a very internalized way with all of these retrograde planets right now. We are in like extreme retrograde energy, and a lot of things are not happening on the surface, and there is not a lot of like visible like change happening in our like 3D physical reality and with people and stuff like that right now. I mean, we're in this process, of course, of this, you know, major fundamental changes that are happening. But just during this period of time when we have all this retrograde energy, it may feel like things are a bit stalled or like a bit held back, or like we're not being able to like see the progress or move forward or see the results in the way that we might like to based on the efforts that we put in or what we might have anticipated at this point in time. But there are a lot of changes going on underneath the surface of things in this retrograde energy, and a lot of it is happening actually today with the way that this Pluto energy is hitting. Both luminaries aspecting Pluto, the moon in Cancer coming to the opposition with Pluto, also therefore the moon in Cancer activating, we're still in black moon energy. So it's not only the Pluto dimension and dynamic of things, this is also illuminating our own shadow side for us and probably bringing up and triggering a lot. This could be triggering a lot of like deep wounds as well, deep traumas, like deep unresolved wounds and painful, like just unhealed trauma within us, maybe bubbling to the surface in this energy as well. And maybe that is some like an aspect of what we are gaining this awareness of with the Mercury Jupiter energy in regards to our own personal truth and what needs to be healed at this point in time. There's also some energy coming through today that I feel like is indicating a lot of the revelations or the understanding that this Mercury Jupiter energy might be bringing to us may have to do with like the work that we need to do at this point in time within ourselves to bring ourselves to a greater state of self-mastery. Again, this idea of this mental power as well, to sort of cultivate the power of our own mind and our own thoughts through this process of like personal work and personal healing and like doing a lot of work on ourself and our mindset and stuff like that in order to really help us come to a greater alignment with what it is that we want to, you know, that authentic truth that I talk about and the resources and the potential that we hold within us and our ability through realigning with that to actually create an experience and a life for ourselves going forward that is so much more of a greater reflection of that which like really fulfills us on this heart and soul level in this 222 year as well, you guys. Like the entire energetic and vibrational push right now this year is to bring us back to a state of authentic alignment with the truth of like our heart and our soul and our like soul's purpose for coming into this reality at this point in time and the mission that we had when we came here and all the gifts that we have, and you know, actually stepping into that and embodying that and utilizing that, and as a result of that being able to experience our life in a way that is so much more fulfilling and so much more purposeful and just really like resonates to us and helps us to attract and magnetize the relationships and the careers and the just life circumstances, the partnerships, life circumstances generally that really fill us up on that heart and soul level. This 222 year, this shift into the age of Aquarius, that is really where universe is trying to bring us right now, to a process of self-actualization so that we can be really like maximizing our experience in this lifetime as universe is on this journey to constantly expand. And we are moving into the age of Aquarius, which is the age of self-knowledge, the age of self-mastery, the age of self-actualization, and the age of co-creation with God and universe. That is the shift that is going on right now. That is the trajectory that we are on right now. And this energy is all pushing to help us gain some type of an awareness, I feel like, about the work that needs to be done in order to help us move forward in that direction. distraction and really free ourselves from maybe the life or the circumstances or what we've created for ourselves at this point in time that is no longer a reflection of that and is therefore holding us back from pursuing this ultimate potential that universe is calling us towards at this period of time, that our souls are calling us towards at this period of time as well. And this energy that we have coming in today and over this entire course of this week and actually leading into our Libra new moon cycle as well is about giving us that awareness. We are gaining a greater conscious awareness about our own personal truths and what needs to be done in order to bring ourselves to a greater state of self-mastery so that we can step into a more fulfilling experience of our own reality. And we're doing it today through this Pluto energy and shining these lights into the darkness, shining the light into the underworld. Pluto rules power in all of its form, and we got a lot of mental energy wrapped up in today as well. So there's a lot of powerful speech, powerful communication, powerful interactions with other people going on, powerful news, information, what we're learning, what we're hearing, what we're talking about. But we still do want to be a bit careful because this is retrograde energy. And the only problem I've been saying with Mercury and Jupiter in their opposition is a lot of times we have such an expansive viewpoint and understanding with Mercury and Jupiter that we fail to see the fine print, that we fail to see the details, that we fail to see like the little intricacies like interwoven into the pattern because we're looking at the overall picture. Right. And so it's important, especially with Mercury retrograde and being at the tail end of this Virgo cycle, heading into the Libra cycle, it's in with all these retrograde planets. It's important that we are not just jumping to conclusions or taking some type of like impulsive, hasty action or choice or decision based on the initial overall view or awakening or awareness that we're gaining, because we are still needing to receive some of like the baselines, the groundwork, like the facts, the details, like that fine print type of stuff. So we need to keep in mind that although we may be really gaining some type of a massive epiphany about something, maybe again, something from the past or something that's been plaguing us for a period of time, or, you know, this is also bringing solutions to things. This is especially again with the Pluto energy. Pluto ultimately regenerates things. This is bringing some also solutions to problems that may have been bothering us for a while in this retrograde energy, and just generally giving us an ability to look at things from a viewpoint and a perspective that we may not have seen things before, and therefore, you know, creating more opportunity for sort of like solutions and stuff to come. But this is also a very solution oriented energy that is coming through as well, which is, you know, beneficial because there is a lot of like conflict and breakdown energy that is going on simultaneously. So, and that's sort of what I was saying. That was what was coming out in the tarot message yesterday. If you watched my report, I was talking about like, you know, these issues that we are navigating and what we may have to, you know, some breakdown that may be going on, but simultaneously these opportunities and these new things coming in embedded all along the way. So we really, you know, we want to be open-minded and we want to have our eyes open to the offers that are coming to us in this energy and not just so focused on, you know, what we are like transitioning, what we are losing, I guess you could say. But let's get into like the specifics of this energy. Moon in opposition to Pluto, you guys, this is profound, powerful, intense emotions, right? The moon rules our emotions and also encounters and interactions with other people, because if people are feeling this way on an emotional level, when they're having a conversation with someone, it's probably going to come out because our emotions drive a lot of, you know, our actions and our thoughts and our behaviors. And so if people are being sort of influenced by this very powerful subconscious force that Pluto represents on an emotional level, then there are likely to be some more profound and powerful conversations, interactions, and just interpersonal dynamics going on in this energy. This strong subconscious influence impacting feelings and actions that is likely to come out in our interplays with other people. And the conflicts that are going on and playing out in this energy, you guys, are likely, again, to be revealing a lot about the true inner workings of things. This is shining a light into like the root issue, like the like initial motivating driving force, like whatever conflicts are surfacing, like I just said, like how it's playing out is likely to give us some type of a glimpse into the origin point or like what the real reason is besides this, behind this conflict, which is what is necessary to purify, purge, regenerate, heal, transform all of these Pluto energies. Guilt, jealousy, possessiveness, and the desire to possess or control others or their emotions are also things that may surface in this energy. And it's this aspect of it can be very unconscious, because we're talking about the moon, we're talking about Pluto also, like the depths of our psyche and this powerful influence. People may also be like unconsciously picking up on the power that other people are carrying today and acting out in ways to like diminish that or sabotage that somehow, feeling threatened by it. This is the type of energy where people may just be like acting real like aggressive or ugly, or trying to control like stuff that you're doing for literally no reason. And it may be because they are sensing your like they are unconsciously sensing your own power and are feeling threatened by that. So we're trying to like go ahead and take action to sort of stomp that out before it, you know, dominates them in some type of way. But again, this is likely playing out on a very unconscious level. Like people don't even, not even thinking about why they're behaving or acting the way that they do, but it may have to do with an unconscious reaction to like various power plays that people are psychically or intuitively picking up on without realizing. This, again, very intense conversations going on, especially considering, you guys, the ruler of this cycle right now, Mercury, is in the opposition to Jupiter, and Mercury's all about conversations and what we're talking about and what we're thinking about. So there may be some real like occult type conversations, or like more like spiritual based, like looking into the truth, like power, like see, like just really trying to get to the root of things or understand things, like people talking about it today, or like more of this is like woo-woo type of stuff, or conspiracies, I guess that's what I'm trying to say, like the secret things that people don't normally look at or don't normally talk about may for some reason be like on blast in this energy, or personalities that are more associated with that type of stuff, like on a grander scale, may have some type of prominence in this energy as well. Very interesting. But like this is energy that is really shining a light and putting a highlight on the secret aspects of what goes on behind the scenes, the secret like powerful forces and their role in our reality, and like trying to like understand how they're playing out. And also, again, we're in this black moon energy too, for at least, you know, the part of the day when, because the moon actually will move into Leo by the later part of the day, because Pluto right now is at 27 Capricorn. So the moon and the sun is at 28 degrees of Virgo. So this is when the moon is in the very late degrees of Cancer. So the moon, there will be a shift that goes on over the course of the day. The later half of the day is likely to be a little bit more like perhaps like upbeat than the beginning half of the day. We're likely to start out in some very heavy energy. But again, this is also represented through this transformation and shining the light into the darkness, because it's like once the light shines into the darkness, like once we have both these luminaries on Pluto, then the sun moves in, or then the moon moves into Leo, which is the sign of what? Which is the sign of the sun. And so here we are back in the light again, with like the light of this conscious awareness and this truth that we gained while we were in all of this Pluto energy and shadow energy, like navigating the underworld. So there is likely to be actually sort of like a palpable shift that goes on throughout the course of the day later towards the evening, but for the majority of the day, you guys, we are really in some of this intense energy, bringing up these shadow side issues as well, though also helping us to gain this conscious awareness. With the moon and trine to Pluto, this is actually a really good energy to have the black moon activated, because this is really helping us see into the root of our own issues, which is what we need to do in order to like take back control and power over our own mind and over our own consciousness, which again, we have the position of the sun today, 28 Virgo, a bald-headed man and uniform who has seized power. Now, this can be interpreted a lot of ways, but one interpretation of this, we're talking about the head. We're talking about the bald head. This is like a very specific reference to me to like the mind and the head who has seized power. This is like a forceful seizure with Pluto there as well, like a forceful seizure of our own mental power, like coming back into our own sense of self-empowerment on a very mentalized level. And then with the Mercury Jupiter as well in a very expanded way. So could be, you know, there could be a lot of people vying for the like power of influence, mental influence over others in this energy, but it's also indicating to me some type of collective seizure of our own mental energy back in this place of self-empowerment with this Pluto sun trine specifically, because Pluto trine the sun, this is also a very self-empowering aspect. Pluto trine the moon, or moon opposite Pluto, this is a little bit more challenging, and this can really create conflicts going on, power dynamics and stuff like that. But Sun trine to Pluto, this really has a tendency of putting us in a place of self-empowerment and giving us an ability to be quite forceful and assertive and, you know, kind of achieve our objectives in a kind of like a powerful way when we have this playing out. Let's talk more specifically, I guess, now about the Sun and trine to Pluto. This aspect brings these intense, powerful experiences, just generally has a tendency. So on one hand, we have like people's emotions aligned with this powerful energy. So it's like these encounters and these conversations spilling out from this very powerful place as a result of like this Pluto energy on the emotional level. But then we're talking about the Sun and trine to Pluto. This is like universe facilitating our interaction with these powerful experiences so that we can learn everything possible about the inner workings of whatever it specifically is that we happen to be navigating in this energy, whatever we're involved in this energy. This is universe trying to facilitate our ability to see into the shadows, to see into the depths, to really understand the inner nature, the root issues, like the like inner workings of whatever it is that is playing out for us, wherever we're navigating in this energy. This is tremendous energy for any type of investigation, study, self-analysis for sure, again, especially in this Black Moon energy. And also it's like pushing us to not only like get an understanding of what is going on, but to also decide what parts of our life based on that understanding are in need of some type of reformation. And then to actually have the energy and again this like power that's fueling us to go ahead and make those specific reformations, to discern what it is that needs to be transformed and regenerated, and then to like actually go ahead and execute, go ahead and do it. And again, this is happening in earth signs, the Sun in Virgo, Pluto in Capricorn. So this is things tangibly, physically happening. This is a facilitated, like on the ground transformation in one way or another. Very transformative energies helping us to move easily and make changes that may have been more difficult before or in other energy. And also there's a tendency to really be able to drive sort of like more of a sense of personal satisfaction out of the changes that we make in this energy as well, because we're talking about the Sun. This is like, this is our character and this is our spirit and this is our consciousness. And it's like with the trine, it's like we are like not resisting these changes. It's like we're flowing with the universe and we're feeling pretty good about the progress that we're making in our like conquest to conquer our own issues, essentially, in this energy. That's what this is. This is us like conquering our own setbacks, like looking for what is not working within us or within our lives and making the necessary repairs in order to improve that or to evolve it or to set it right somehow. This also brings a strong sense, like I was saying, of self-empowerment and an ability to act with force and impact to make things happen that we want for ourselves in this energy. However, and you know, I mentioned this earlier when we were talking about the Moon in opposition to Pluto, like we need to be very careful and we need to not be exerting or trying to control or influence or dominate or manipulate or be coercive towards other people's emotions in this energy, because that projection can a lot of times happen, you know, feeling unconsciously or subconsciously threatened by somebody else's power in some type of way, and therefore acting out to control or to limit their whatever, like trying to control their emotions or manipulate or something in order to, you know, maintain our own sense of feeling and power and control in the situation. We want to be very careful with that. And even though we may be also feeling this stronger sense of ability to be in our sense of self-empowerment and to act with force and to act with impact today, we cannot use this energy ruthlessly or for selfish purposes, because that will actually set in motion a sequence of events that will not be benefiting you in the long run, especially in this Mercury Jupiter energy and the other things that we have playing out on the side. Saturn square Uranus, Uranus trine Venus, like that is not the way that we want to go. We want to use this energy to make our life evolve and grow upwards, to regenerate ourselves in a way that is birthing, you know, the next phase of our life, our reality, our growth in a direction that is beneficial to what we wish to experience consciously moving forward. Something that will make a positive impact or a positive impression on someone. This is the way that we want to use this forceful exertion of our energy today. If we're going to make an impact, we want it to be a positive one that benefits us somehow and not one to, you know, like control or to dominate or to like ruthlessly exert force or power over someone or some type of situation for one reason or another. Great time for putting energy into work or jobs that like have to be done. Things that perhaps we've been procrastinating or like not wanting to deal with. Something about using this period of time to get that type of stuff done. It has a tendency of actually having like an additional benefit of teaching us about something about ourselves somehow. Like, I don't, you know, it's just like the way that this energy works is like if we do get involved in this energy and trying to repair various of our areas of our lives that maybe we'd put off at other points in time, it's like we also simultaneously may have this self-reflection about something else that benefits us somehow in the future or going forward or at a later point in time, or just it contributes to our personal growth and expansion. So all this going on, you guys, the sun, like I said, in the sign of Virgo right now, ruled by Mercury retrograde in the opposition to Pluto as we have, or in the opposition to Jupiter, sorry, as we have this sun trining Pluto from the sign of Virgo energy playing out. So the position of the sun, like I've said, is ruled by Mercury. Mercury in the opposition to Jupiter. Personal truth, reevaluating our own personal truth. Also Mercury right now in the sign of Libra about what it is that we truly want. Like that's the other side of this. It's like, yeah, we are figuring out these personal truths and everything, but then we gotta bring the Libra dimension and dynamic into it in regards to like how we wanna relate and connect to others going forwards, how we wanna spend our money, what our idea is of like a pleasant social situation, like what we want to spend our time and money and energy on, like what is the worth of what we have to contribute, and like how comfortable are we in our current circumstances, and what can we do to make our general experience more pleasurable, either in terms of just like, you know, what we're doing on a day-to-day basis with this Virgo energy, or also in terms of our relationships or our financial situations with the Libra energy going on as well. So these are the type of things that are coming up and that, you know, we are really trying to figure out, because going forward throughout this Libra cycle, there's going to be some major changes that are going on. Things are really going to start to realign, and we're going to really need to have a very solid, grounded footing in what we want for ourselves so that we can make some choices to move in that direction and not sort of keep ourselves stuck in stagnancy because of a lack of understanding of what we want, or, you know, draw more karmic situations to ourselves that are trying to like teach us, you know, this lesson and show us what it is that we really want so that we can get back on the proper course. This is a period of time where we really need to be getting clear with ourselves about who we are, what we stand for, what our values are, what makes us feel comfortable, what truly gives us pleasure, the type of people that we like to relate and connect with, and like what we want, how we want to spend our time and energy going forward, and the type of people that we want to spend it with. That is what we are figuring out in this energy. And it really is like we're going into the underworld today on all of these levels: black moon, moon opposite Pluto, sunshine Pluto, but simultaneously we're going up as well. Like we're going up to the highest levels of expansion with Mercury ruling this energy in the opposition to Jupiter. We're seeing under and over today. We're seeing like above and below. We really are getting like this 360 view of things. And like I said, we may not be seeing the specific detail and like the fine print and like the particular facts of everything, but we are getting this like massive overall like 360 degree view of the circumstances and situations that we're dealing with, and specifically again pertaining to things that we may not have understood, that we may have been looking at the wrong way, or that may have been hidden from us in one way or another from the past. And you know, the position also of the sun today, that bald-headed man in uniform who has seized power, the power of our mindset, perspective, thoughts, viewpoints, understanding to determine our reality. And also that is a very important part of our transition of the age of Aquarius, and a lesson that we need to learn. You know, that again, like I feel like that is sort of what universe is indicating, some of the inner work that needs to go on right now in order to like truly help us transition personally into our new paradigm of fulfillment is this work on our mindset, flipping our perspective and aligning our mind or our attitude, or just gaining a better sense of like conscious connection, I guess, like to the various facets of our own mind going forward. I feel like the energy is indicating this shift in perspective. This is what empowers us to, you know, see ourselves and our potential differently and bring back these lost opportunities and help us to realign our trajectory in a way that is conducive, again, to this path that is leading towards this fulfillment, which is what universe really wants to bring to us at this period of time. So the perspective that we're gaining, like it really is a powerful mindset switch. I feel like that is helping us to understand the work that we need to do within ourselves to realign our circumstances in a way, or our own vibration, our own frequency, or, you know, heal ourselves, or just, you know, go through this process of rebuilding ourselves internally in such a way that is freeing us and releasing us to align with the more fulfilling experiences going forward that universe is trying to bring to us in this 222 year. Also, again, could be a very big information day that changes a lot for us. Big news, big information. Like I said in the beginning, like somebody's like big mouth that is just like spilling the tea all over the place and letting you know something that maybe you haven't known or that you've needed to know. Also, though, we do have Venus still in trine to Uranus. We have Saturn in square to Uranus. Lots and lots of relationship breakdowns going on right now. And not only relationships, it's like breaking free from like all types of like long-standing commitments, agreements, contracts even, and stuff like that, that are just, we just can't do it anymore. Like very much a breakdown, I feel like, in long-standing commitments, responsibilities, even careers and stuff like that. Like as a result of this rediscovering of like our own preferences and stuff like that, and no longer being able to continue with whatever we got going on, I feel like is coming through with that. It's definitely marking a transitional period right now in people's lives. Like I feel like collectively, like a lot of people, I feel like, are ending one chapter right now that may have been going on for a very, very long period of time. And I feel like it's sort of happening unexpectedly, and we're like about to start this like radically, radically different one that changes the whole context of the story. Like this is the massive turning point that nobody saw coming in each of our individual stories. And the turning point is, right, like the transition is, we're going from like there being an outside narrator telling the story to us self-authoring our own story. Like that's the shift from like the operating out of the subconscious programming to operating out of the conscious awareness. And that is the shift of the ages, you guys. That is the great awakening. That is this process of self-actualization that I talk about. It is the shift from an unconscious experience of reality to consciously creating reality. And I feel like that is very paralleled in the concept of, like I just said, us going from some type of like narrator that was telling the story for us to us being the like self-authoring our own story going forward, unconscious to conscious co-creation. That's the shift. That's the transition. That's where we're going. And these aspects are pushing us to that conscious realization so that we can, you know, pick up the pen and write our own story going forward instead of being at the mercy of whatever we are creating for ourselves from that unconscious level, as a result of universe trying to help us gain this awareness so that we can break through that and become the authors of our own story going forward. Definitely this transitional period, like I said, and I do feel like after we go through this period of time, or, you know, just over the course of the next couple of weeks, generally, as we're heading through the Libra cycle and, you know, people are making these choices and making these decisions and coming back, rediscovering, you know, what they really want and gaining a better view of what they want their life to go look like going forward. I feel like people are going to be acting and behaving a lot differently. But, you know, today we've got so much going on. We've got Black Moon energy. We've got Moon opposite Pluto, Sun trine Pluto, Mercury opposite Jupiter, Saturn square Uranus, only 1 degree off. Yeah, Venus trine Uranus, and also Venus and Mars are still in a loose square as well. So, you know, when like the whole combination, the whole package of all of this, basically to me, like lies, deception, toxicity, corruption, manipulation, bondage, servitude, sacrifice, false pretenses of all kinds, all being rooted out in this energy, super intense, dark secrets, hidden motives, power, influence, deceit. This cycle is about the restoration of justice, restoring balance, righting things. And this is like, to me, very, very strong, the truth will set you free energy. So I was saying earlier, like, I feel like people are going to be coming clean about some stuff. Like, I feel like this is the type of energy that, like, it's like if you've got a guilty conscience about something, it might be weighing so heavy and driving you so crazy that you just need to come clean in order to like go on with your life. Like, I feel like that is what is sort of what this energy is boiling down to as well. Like, people just not being able to handle the guilt of stuff anymore, or like not being able to keep the skeletons in the closet and just like really needing to let it all out to like save their soul. Like, I feel like that is what is really coming through you guys in this energy as it's playing out today. So that's what I have to say in terms of the astrology. Like, it is big time. Like, we are in big time energy. Like, as above, so below today. Like, we are seeing it all. Like, we are going down into the depths of the underworld, even with the black moon activated as well. And simultaneously with Mercury and Jupiter, we are seeing, you know, we're seeing from the top of the mountain also. It's very interesting polarity of viewpoints from which we are being able to gain, though it would need to be in order to gain this expansive perspective with Mercury and Jupiter about us and others. This is very much in relation to our personal truth and what's been going on in relationship dynamics with others, with the Aries Libra axis being hosting Mercury right now and Jupiter in their opposition. So, whoa, you guys, very interesting to see what plays out in this energy. Let's talk about the tarot cards for a minute. Got some information coming, got some messaging coming. Interesting, super interesting, actually, how this came out today. Feel like it is really pretty much, though, right in alignment with what universe is indicating through the astrology. We've got a bunch of cards coming out today too, which also doesn't surprise me because of this big information. There may be, like, it may be another very busy information day with Mercury in opposition to Jupiter. There may just be, it might be like news and news and news and news and just like expanded. This is just expanding the field of communication. So there's a lot that needed to be communicated today. But anyways, this is the message as we have it coming out. And it's actually like a great message. The first card that we have coming out, though, is the Ace of Swords in reverse, followed by the Ten of Cups, followed by, we got a 2-2-2 today in a row coming out in our cards. We got the Two of Pentacles, we got the Two of Swords, and then we got the Two of Wands. The only card that we were missing in this spread of twos, you guys, is the Two of Cups, and that tells us something about this message today as well. We also got the Eight of Pentacles, need to get some work going on, and we got the Ten of Pentacles. We've got like two wish fulfillment cards coming out here, you guys. See, we've got two tens, the two best tens. We've got the Ten of Cups. This is that emotional fulfillment. Oh, look at that. And then we've got the Ten of Pentacles. This is like a long-term lasting, like, happy life, okay? And then on the back of the deck, we've got the Ten of Pentacles, or the King of Pentacles, okay? So what this message to me, like, my little summary synopsis of this message that I wrote was, the only thing standing between us and our true happiness right now is the recognition of the work that needs to be done to come to a point of self-mastery where we can really co-create this experience for ourselves going forward with God and universe. And that's a lot what I was also feeling like the message was coming through in terms of the astrology that we have going on today. And the reason that I'm saying that is because, first of all, the first card that we have coming out of the deck, and actually the only reversed card that we had today, was the Ace of Swords. And this is lacking clarity, not understanding, not knowing, not having the inspiration, not like having the idea or something, just like not having the clarity about something in some type of a way. And then, but after that, we have like the Ten of Cups. Like, this is like our wish fulfillment right here. This is like the heart's like true, what the heart truly yearns for and wants. And then we have this sequence of twos, right? Starting with the Two of Pentacles, this is talking about some choices that we are in the process of needing to make. And then we're talking about the Two of Swords. This is coming to a point where we maybe feel like we've hit a wall and we don't know how to make the choice, or we feel like no choice that we are going to make is going to, you know, get us to what we really want. And then we're talking about the Two of Wands right here. This is kind of considering, okay, you know, like, should I do it? Like, should I stay or should I go? Like, should I wait, or is it time for me to like take some action? And this is sort of describing like this decision-making phase that we may have been sort of in. But But then, in the, like I said, the only two that we are missing is the Two of Cups, which really represents the 222 energy, because that's sort of like this divine inner harmony, this soul fulfillment, the Two of Cups. This is like divine union based on that, like authentic heart-based truth and stuff like that, which is also very much represented through the Ten of Cups. But then we're talking about the Eight of Pentacles. So this is something that we are working on, right? And it's interesting because we have the Eight of Pentacles and this guy is working really hard, but he's also facing this, he's facing all of these cards and ultimately the Ace of Swords in reverse. And then the last card that we have is the Ten of Pentacles. I feel like to me, this is talking again about like, you know, where we wish to go. And then with the King of Pentacles on the back of the deck, I feel like this is talking about, like I said, in order for us to make this choice, to make this decision that is moving us in the direction that is going to lead us to this path of fulfillment and like love and just feeling like our purpose and like our life is meaningful and like we have gotten like all of the juice out of the fruit, you know what I mean? Like there is just this inner work that needs to go on. And I feel like this is talking about anywhere that we feel stuck or held back right now with all of these twos, and especially lacking the Two of Cups energy, the Two of Swords, the Two of Pentacles, the Two of Wands, like anywhere that we are feeling still stuck right now and like we don't know what to do or which direction to move in or what to go in going forward. I feel like this is saying it's because we're in this process right now of gaining this awareness. Like we're just perhaps like lacking this last bit of truth, this last bit of clarity, which may be coming to us in this energy. And really like that is the only like gaining an awareness of what we need to do, what we need to work on, what we need to fix within ourselves, within our mindset, right? This is the Ace of Swords in reverse. There's some work that needs to go on to our own mindset, to our own viewpoint, in order to release us from this Two of Wands, Swords, Pentacles energy so that we can move, you know, forward in this wish fulfillment energy, this Ten of Pentacles, this Ten of Cups. But it's saying, you know, we really need to come into our King of Pentacles in order to make that happen. And the King of Pentacles is very, very much so in a state of self-mastery. He knows how to co-create the world around him, and he does it abundantly and fruitfully. You know what I mean? Like this process is universe trying to bring us into our own state of self-mastery, being like the king of our own kingdom, sitting on our own throne of co-creation in the kingdom that we've created through our own conscious awareness and ability to apply that in a way that gets us the results that we want in our physical, tangible world with this Sun, Trine, Pluto happening in these earth signs. But I feel like this is saying what this energy is bringing to us now is helping us to gain a conscious awareness of what we need to work on within ourselves to come to this greater state of self-mastery so that we can overcome these limitations and these setbacks as a result of perhaps this indecisiveness or inability to see clearly or feeling held back or like we don't know which way to go. It's like we still need some information or some mindset shift perspective. We need to learn something that is going to bring us to a greater state of self-empowerment. Again, also Sun trining the Pluto in the earth signs. This is like King of Pentacles energy. This is very self-empowered energy to ground and create and manifest in the physical reality. But, you know, we just really need to get clear about the direction that we want to take things and who we are and what we want and what our authentic truth is in order to go in that new direction. And again, all of these twos here minus the Two of Cups, it's like with the retrograde energy, we're still in a place of indecision and it's not quite time to move forward yet because we are not yet a true reflection of that which is going to fill us up on that heart and soul level. Like there's still some adjustments that need to go on to our vibration, our frequency before we will be able to truly attract and you know, like begin to like really go through this process of stepping into our new like reality with the proper alignments for us. So that's what I feel like the tarot message is saying for us today, you guys. Let's get one more card, synchronicity card, God, Spirit, Universe. What additional information do we need to know today? What advice, guidance should we take that can help us as we are navigating the energy of today. We have two cards coming out, so we are going to use those. Drink of inspiration, and things are not as they seem. So drink of inspiration, things are not as they seem. This is what we are working with in terms of the synchronicity cards for today. Drink of inspiration. It says, as cold water to a weary soul, so is good news from a far country. Proverbs 25:25. You thirst spiritually when you lack joy, peace, inspiration, and confidence. Claim the living waters of the Almighty flow through you as wisdom, truth, and beauty, and as joy, harmony, power, and love. Accept this all as your own, and you will then draw from your spiritual waters all you need to give sustenance to your soul. So one piece of advice today, things are not as they seem, and he shall separate them from one another as a shepherd divideth his sheep from the goats. Matthew 25:32. You must know the difference between the false and the true. Remove the false and negative thoughts from your mind. Come to a definite decision in your mind that God within you is all powerful and all wise, and nothing can oppose God. Remove the fear and the false thoughts. They are not real. Know God is opening doors for you. Know the path is being cleared. Know success and achievement is on its way to you. So long as you remove the false fears. And I feel like also this card is specifically also referencing this tarot message that came out, talking about like perhaps this inverted perception that we have going on right now, and the need to release ourselves from any mental, darker, negative, fear-based mindsets or attitudes that are preventing us from being able to really receive the divine image of what is in store for us while we, after we are going through these shifts and these changes and surrendering to the process. So very relevant yet again with these synchronicity cards. That is our advice and guidance from God, Spirit, Universe, message from the stars, message from the cards. That's what I have to say to today, you guys. I hope you guys liked it. I hope I was able to provide something for you that can give you a little bit of whatever you may be looking for as you go throughout your day today. If you guys did like this video, please give me a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel. Please hit that subscribe button, you guys, below this video. Totally free, and it really helps my channel grow when you do that. I'm really trying to get to 1,000 subscribers, and we are getting close, so thank you guys so much. Share it with your friends. Also, if you think that they would like this video and be interested in this type of astrology content, leave me comments as well, you guys. I really, really appreciate your comments. I appreciate your feedback. I'm so grateful for each and every one of you being here. I love you guys so much. I have a Facebook page, a Facebook group, a website, and some other social media stuff. Those are in my description box below, and come back with me tomorrow, you guys. It is the equinox. We've got more energy to talk about. I'll be here. You should be here too. You don't want to miss it, and I will see you then, everybody. Have a beautiful day, and until tomorrow, bye, guys.